Hello, hi everybody, and welcome to this week's live grammar lesson. My name's Jo. Nice to see you there in the chat, the people who are with us already. Why don't you say hi, say hello in the comments, tell me where you are, where are you in the world, where are you joining us from today? So I'm in France. It's a nice sunny day here today. So yeah, just say hi in the comments to everybody so that we know which different countries we've got today. Hello, Aline. Hi, you're in Romania. Who else have we got here? Mewish from Pakistan. Hello to you. We usually have lots and lots of different countries. Always a pleasure to see everyone around the world. Hi, Ella in Ukraine. Hello, Hannah in Egypt. Hi, Marie in Argentina. Hi there, Edward in Japan. Julia, hello to you, Myanmar. Hi, Fatima in Lebanon. Hello, Yuli. Hi, I'm fine, thanks. How are you? Yuli there in Hong Kong. Hello, Rafia from Libya, but living in the UK, I think I read there. Hi, Safa in Paris. Hello to you. Said Jaget, I'm sorry if I've pronounced that wrong, in Azerbaijan. Tung in Vietnam, hello. Okay, lots of different countries. Great to see you. Nice to have you all with us. I hope that you would join in as much as possible with us in the comments today. So let's have a look, shall we, while other people are joining. Let's have a look in a bit more detail at what we're going to do in today's session. So we'll start today with an introduction to the topic. And the topic today is life decisions. Then we'll have our grammar. So today's grammar is third and mixed conditionals. Then there'll be a little quiz to see what you remember. And then it will be your turn to write and to practice the kind of language that we've had today and the grammar, by writing some sentences and comments there in the chat. Okay, so hi to everybody that's joined us from all of the different countries, Philippines, Egypt, Bangladesh, Uzbekistan, Ukraine. Okay, brilliant. Okay, so let's get started, shall we, with today's topic, which is life decisions. So we've got a few questions for you, two questions there that you can see on the screen. So can you answer these questions for us in the comments? What are the times in our lives when we make important decisions? And what are these decisions often about? Okay, so have a think about those two questions. The times in our lives when we make important decisions. And what sort of decisions are these? What are the decisions often about? What do you think? You could think of your own personal experiences or things that you've read or seen in films, perhaps, or people that you know. What do you think? Okay, I've got some answers coming in now. Marriage, says Mio. Yes, okay, good idea. Abo, decisions about work and the future. Absolutely, good. Ha also says marriage. Okay, that's a big one, isn't it? A big decision in your life. Yuli, education and career development. Absolutely. Okay, good. Marion says studying. Yep, absolutely. Lots of good ideas coming through here. Choosing, Ella says choose a profession, for instance. Yep, so the time in your life when you're deciding on your future career. Lee says going to university. Yeah, good. Okay, so a lot of comments about jobs, studying, Abia to accept a new job. Yes, absolutely. Okay, lots of good ideas here about family, about jobs, etc. Okay, so I think a lot of you have said these things in the chat. Let's have a look at what we've got here. Life decisions, they could be to do with education and your career. So maybe choosing a field of study, choosing university, deciding on a career path, applying for a job or accepting a job. A lot of you said that. Relationships, beginning or ending romantic relationships. Marriage, lots of you said that too. Major life transitions, moving to a new city or country, starting a family, making lifestyle changes. Okay, I saw lots of comments about that in the comments. And financial matters, saving, investing, budgeting, or work promotions. Amel says, another time is moving to a new house. Yeah, that's a big decision, isn't it? Whether to move and what sort of place that you want to move to. And is it somewhere to do with your job? Just somewhere that you like? Okay, good idea here, Dushani. Migrating to another country. Yes, okay, that's a very big decision. There's a lot at stake there if you decide to go to another country. Okay, lots of good ideas. Full up, expecting a baby. That's a major life transition, definitely. Your life is not the same afterwards. Okay, somebody there, George, says something interesting. It's difficult to decide to leave your country to go to another. Absolutely. Yes, I agree with you. Okay, so yeah, that's your comment there. That's, yeah, I definitely agree with that one. Okay, so this is our topic for today. So life decisions. And I'm going to share a book with you today. It's a book that I read. I think I read it last summer and I really liked it. And it was to do with the topic that we've just been talking about. So we're going to just share, I think we can screen share with you the website there of the book's publisher. And this is the name of the book. It's The Midnight Library. And the author is Matt Haig. So have any of you heard of this book? Have you read this book? And can you guess, if you haven't or if you don't know it, what do you think it could be about? It's called The Midnight Library. And as I've said, it's to do with the topic that we are talking about today, The Midnight Library. Okay, so I think it exists in translations. So perhaps it exists in your language, or perhaps you could have read it in English. Or just heard about it. It does say there it's a multi-million copy bestseller. So lots of people have read the book. Marion says, no, unfortunately, you haven't read the book. Okay, but have you got any idea, Marion? Just by looking at the title, has anybody got any ideas at all what it could be about? The Midnight Library. So a library is somewhere where you go to borrow books or to read books. Shima, I have this one, but I have not finished reading it. Have you started it, Shima? Have you started it already? And if so, what do you think about it so far? Anu, I think it's about making life decisions. Yes, you're on the right track, that's for sure. Mio, I haven't read it, but I think it's about life and experience. Good. Marzena, it could be about changing our lives, or it could be about changes in our lives. Good idea. Have we got any other ideas? Moez says it's about making decisions. Yes, you're definitely got the right idea. Kavita, I think it's about regrets. Yes, that's a good idea too. So regrets, when we feel sort of sad about things that we haven't done. Yuli says, I guess it's about how a person changed their own life. Okay, good. So lots of good ideas there. Shall I give you a little bit more detail? So these are some of the themes in the book. You've got some of them already, I think. Taking opportunities, making choices, following alternative paths, change, experiences, regret, and happiness. And I think we might have a quote for you from the book that could give you a little bit more of an idea. The only thing you're guaranteed in this life is regret if you don't take your shot when you have it. Do you know that expression, to take a shot? If you take a shot at something, it means you try to do it, you try to achieve it. So this quote is saying that if you don't try to achieve what you want, then you might regret. So I think somebody said that they thought the book could be about regrets. May, how small decisions have an impact to our lives. That does actually come up in the book. Yeah. So this character makes that we can see how she could have made different big decisions and different small decisions. I saw lots of really good ideas. I think that you're all maybe going to have to read the book and see exactly what it's about. But I can give you a short summary of the book. Okay, so The Midnight Library by Matt Haig. Nora Seed, this is the main character in the book. That's her name. Nora Seed is feeling bored, disappointed, and unhappy with her life. She discovers a magic library where each book holds a different life she could have lived. If Nora had pursued swimming, she would have become an Olympic champion. She could have had a successful career if she'd followed her passion for music. If she'd made different choices, Nora's life would be different now. She learns to appreciate the value of her own choices and the potential for happiness in her present reality. Okay, so that was just a summary. So basically, what happens, she goes to this library, and each time she reads a book, it's a different story. Like it's a different scenario that if she'd made a different decision, that could be her reality now. But obviously, that none of those realities came true, and in the book, she learns really to appreciate what she has now. Neeraj, which book? So the book is called The Midnight Library, and we just before we showed a screenshot of the cover, not a screenshot, sorry, we shared the publisher's website. So perhaps you could research that afterwards. Just look at The Midnight Library, and you should find it. Okay, so that's a little summary there for you of the book, what happens. And I'd like to just focus now on a part of that summary, because we're going to look in a little bit more detail at some grammar. If Nora had pursued swimming, she would have become an Olympic champion. She could have had a successful career if she'd followed her passion for music. If she'd made different choices, Nora's life would be different now. What are the tenses of the verbs in bold? Can you look at the, so there we've got the verbs in yellow, and have a look and see what are the tenses that you see? What's the grammar that we can see there? Can you tell me in the chat what tenses you can see? A lot of people are asking where they can find the book, where they can buy the book. Maybe you could find it in your local library or a local bookshop, or other, I would recommend looking for it online. Okay, so some people have got some ideas here of the tenses. Mia says conditional three. We can see some conditional three there. Third conditional, not all of it. Aline, you can see some past perfect. Yep, correct. Okay, so the first one, if Nora had pursued, that's some past perfect. Kavita says past perfect tense. Same there for Anu. Ella, also, you can see some past perfect. Yep, good. Past perfect, past in the future. Okay, past perfect and modal perfect. So I think you think the modal would have, could have, plus past participle is what we can see there. Okay, lots of good ideas. Lots of people are saying third conditional verbs and past perfect. Okay. Julia, yes. Okay. And George, third conditional verbs. Okay, so we can see some third conditional, but yes, good, Marzina. Also, we've got some mixed conditional in there. Yeah. Yuli, you've got some grammar details there for us. Yeah. Kavita, mixed conditional and third conditional. Excellent. So we're getting right onto the right track now. Yuli says, if clause is the past perfect and the main clause is the modal and the past perfect. Let's have a look. Let's have a look in detail at the grammar. We're going to have the examples and we're going to see exactly what the structure is. Okay, so first of all, just conditionals in general. We use them to describe the result of a certain condition. So there in yellow, we can see the if clause, and that tells you the condition. So if Nora had pursued swimming, that's the condition. And in pink, the main clause tells you the result. She would have become an Olympic swimmer. So there we go. It doesn't matter if we put the if clause first or the main clause. So it doesn't change the meaning. She would have become an Olympic swimmer if she'd pursued swimming. So they mean exactly the same thing. Okay, so that's conditionals in general. Let's now have a closer look at the third conditional. What is the third conditional? You recognize that we had some third conditionals in that little summary. So we use the third conditional to imagine a different past. So we imagine a change in a past situation and the different result of that change. So let's look at the examples. She could have had a successful career if she'd followed her passion for music. She might have become an Olympic swimmer if she hadn't given up swimming. So the structure is usually if plus past perfect. So that's in the if clause, which is the yellow one. And in the main clause, we have would, could, might, have, plus the past participle. So that's what you see there in pink. Amal, we use the third conditional to express regret. We can, exactly, because we're talking about something in the past, and if that were different, how things would be different now. It could be a regret. Not always, but it could be. May, something which had already happened in the past and cannot change now. Exactly, it's finished. It can't change, but we are imagining how things could be different, what changes there could have been if we had made some different decisions in the past. Okay, so that's the third conditional. And what about the mixed conditional? So we can use mixed conditionals when we imagine a change in the past that results in a different present. Okay, so we're going from past to present. Here's the example from the book. If she'd made different choices, if she'd made different choices, Nora's life would be different now. And if she hadn't ended her relationship with Mark, she wouldn't be single. Okay, so we can see the second example there is with a negative. So the structure there is usually if plus past perfect, that's in the if clause, and then would plus infinitive in the main clause. Okay, there we go. So that's the mixed conditional. That's a change in the past, which gives a different result, a different situation in the present. Okay, so I hope that the grammar explanation was clear and that it was useful. Okay, Facebook user says, I don't understand. Which part don't you understand in particular? Is it the third conditional or the mixed conditional? The third conditional, we are imagining if the past had been different, then it would be a different past. If we had made a different decision in the past would be different. With the mixed conditional, we're imagining if there had been a different decision in the past, the present would be different. Okay, so the third conditional is the past and the past, and the mixed conditional is the past and the present. I think that if we have a little bit of practice, things might become a bit clearer for you. So, why don't we have the quiz? So, if we move on to the quiz, we've got some questions, and we can see a little bit more detail about these structures. Okay, you got it. Thank you. Brilliant. Okay, so the quiz number one. So, what we're going to do is decide which of these options, A, B, or C, is the correct way to complete this conditional sentence. So, if she the penalty, they would have won the match. So, is it A, would score? B, had scored, or C, would have scored. If she would score, if she had scored, or if she would have scored, which is the correct one? Mona says it's had scored, so does Ali. And so does Ella. Noon says had scored. That's what I'm seeing. Most of the answers here are B, had scored, same for Edward. Okay, so I think May says B. Everybody seems to agree there that had scored is the correct option. Shall we see if you're right? Yes, you are. If she had scored the penalty, we could make a contraction there if we wanted. We could say if she'd scored the penalty. So there, that's the if clause with the past perfect, if she had scored. And okay, so that's the third conditional that we can see there. If she'd scored in the past, they would have won in the past. Okay, excellent. Well done, everybody who got the right answer there. Well, let's have a look at number two. So, have we got a second quiz question for you? Yes, we have. Okay. If my parents hadn't moved to Australia. So, what's the correct option here? Is it A, wouldn't meet, B, won't meet, or C, wouldn't have met? So, is it A, we wouldn't meet, B, we won't meet, or C, we wouldn't have met? What does everybody think about that? Okay, I can see lots of people putting answers now for number two. Ella says it's C. Aline says wouldn't have met. Okay. Yuli also says C. Good. Ali also says C, wouldn't have met. Okay, another C. Wouldn't have met. Okay, lots of agreement on this one as well. Would not have met. Yep, that means the same thing. So, is everybody who said C, are they right? Yes. Okay. So, we wouldn't have met if my parents hadn't moved to Australia. So, there wouldn't plus have plus past participle in the main clause and past perfect in the if clause. So, that means it's a third conditional. Okay. Number three, this is the last question now for our quiz. Okay, if I'd bought that flat 10 years ago, it's worth a lot of money now. How can we complete this correctly? Is it with A, would be, B, had been, or C, will be? If I'd bought that flat 10 years ago, it would be, it had been, or it will be worth a lot of money now. Okay, there seems three people saying A. George as well says it's A. Ali also says A, would be. Okay. A, that's what most people are saying in the comments, would be. Kavita says mixed conditional. Okay, good. Lots of agreement there. Again, let's see. A few people are saying C, but let's check the, yes, the correct answer is A, would be. If I'd bought that flat 10 years ago, it would be worth a lot of money now. So a different past, the present would be different. So that's a mixed conditional, past and present. Okay, so well done, everybody. I think the fact that everybody's got most of those right means that you're pretty good at third and mixed conditionals with the structure. Okay, so now we can have a little bit more practice. I'm going to show you some pictures of different situations, and I'd like you to imagine what's happening in these situations, and then you can write some sentences in the comments using third conditional or mixed conditional, and let's see how you get on. So have we got the first picture for you? Okay, so here we can see a girl who doesn't look very happy. Looks like she's got a test paper or an exam paper in her hand with an F. Poor thing. F means fail. Okay, so she hasn't passed her exam or her test. She's failed. What could we say here? If she would have, or she wouldn't have, So choose your own verbs. Choose your own verbs. Use your own ideas to complete the sentences. This is making me think of my son who had an important exam this morning. Just wondering about how much revision he did. If he could have done a bit more revision. Anyway, I hope that he hasn't failed his exam. What have you got here? Have you got some conditional sentences for us? Abbo, if she had studied, she wouldn't have failed. Okay, yes, perfect. So we've got past perfect there, if she had studied. If she had studied well, they would have passed her exam. Maybe you could put that she would have passed her exam. If she had studied well, she would have passed her exam. If she had studied hard, she wouldn't have failed. Yes, that's another good one, Fatima. If she hadn't got F, she would be happy now. Okay, good. There you've used a nice mixed conditional. That's nice. I can see lots of other ideas. Lee, if she had studied harder, she would have had a better mark. Yuli, I like your idea. If she hadn't played till midnight before the test, she would have got a better score. That's a nice one. Okay, good. So I think there we've had lots of good ideas there with the third conditionals, and I also saw some mixed conditionals. Yeah, I like that one. If she hadn't played till midnight before the test, she would have got a much better score. Okay, excellent. Okay, so that's a good third conditional sentence there. Okay, if she'd studied hard, she wouldn't have failed. Okay, let's have a look at another picture. What do you think is happening in this picture? So we can see somebody there who's looking worried and maybe a little bit confused. And she's looking at her mobile phone. Maybe she's looking at her internet banking. And now maybe she's got her credit card in her hand. What do you think? Have you got any ideas of how we could complete this sentence? She wouldn't have lost all her money if... Okay, what do you think we could put there? Abbo's got an idea. If she had planned her business well. Good, yes. Okay, a good third conditional there. She wouldn't have lost all her money if she had been careful, Syed. Yeah, excellent. Any other ideas? If she had... Okay, if she would be more clever. So let's remember the structure. With the if clause, it's the past perfect. So if she had been, or contraction, if she'd been more clever. Okay, so remember that the would doesn't come in the if clause. Okay, the would comes in the main clause. We can already see the wouldn't there in the main clause. She wouldn't have lost all her money if she had been careful with her online purchasing. Okay, good sentence. Yeah, excellent. She wouldn't have lost all her money if she had not played in the casino. Okay, so you think she's gambled all her money away. Okay, good idea. Yuli, she wouldn't have lost all her money if she'd paid more attention to cybercrime. Yes, okay, so there's lots of different ideas there of how she's lost her money. Natalia, if she hadn't been so naive. Good idea. Lots of different ideas there of how she lost her money. Okay. And lots of really good use there, I can see, of the conditional, of the third conditional. She wouldn't have lost all her money if her account didn't get hacked by hackers. That's how we could put that. Or if her account hadn't been hacked, we could say. She wouldn't have lost all her money if her account hadn't been hacked. Okay. Shall we move on to the next one? Oh, we've got one more. Sinan says, she wouldn't have lost all her money if she hadn't divorced with her husband. Okay, that's another idea of how she's lost all her money. Ah, why am I Facebook user? I am Diana. Hi, Diana. Not sure why we're not seeing your name, but now I know that it's you. So nice to have you with us today, Diana. Okay, so I think maybe we can move to another one, even though I'm still seeing good ideas coming through. I like them all. They're great. Okay, what's the situation here? So I can see somebody who's working in an office and they look like they've got a lot of work to do. Do they look happy with the situation? I'm not sure. So what do you think? How could things be different for this person? If she'd done something different, made a different decision in the past. What do you think? If she'd or if she hadn't. So you can either give us a positive sentence or a negative one. What do you think? What's her situation? Do you think she likes her job? Do you think maybe she wishes she had a different job? Has she got too much work? What do you think? What do you think we could put here to describe this situation using a conditional? Okay, I can see some ideas now Hello, Kung Fu Panda. If she hadn't gone to the bar yesterday night, she wouldn't be confused now. Okay, so you think maybe she had a bit too much to drink last night and now she can't really think properly for her work. Okay. Safar, if she'd organized her time, she would have finished the project on time. Okay, so you think she's a little bit stressed because she hasn't got time to do her work. Okay, good idea. Oh, sorry, I can't read your name, but if she had asked for help, she would have finished her report on time. Yes, I like that one. Okay, lots of good third conditionals here. If she hadn't come late, she would have gone back home on time. Okay, so remember that we've got the past participle is come. Okay, lots more ideas here about her work and her situation. Kavita, if she had completed her work on time, she wouldn't have a backlog. Yes, okay, a backlog. She's behind on her work. Okay, good. Mona, if she hadn't, I think this one's a hadn't that you're using here. If she hadn't wasted her time, she would have finished the project. Okay, nice, nice sentence. Okay, excellent. Good work, everyone. I'm trying to read as many as I can as they go through. Yeah, all good ideas. If she'd found out the mistakes earlier, she wouldn't have been perplexed and overwhelmed. So remember, we need wouldn't have plus past participle. So there, the past participle been. Lee, if she'd organized her work more logically, she wouldn't have to work overtime now. Okay, yes. Okay, so nice mixed conditional there. You're saying if she'd done something different in the past, things would be different now. Okay, yes. Good work. Okay. I think we've got one last one of these pictures. Okay, imagine what's the situation here. We've got somebody with an umbrella. It's raining. Probably, maybe they're somewhere in the rainy UK, possibly. And she's thinking about a different life, maybe, that she could have now. What do you think? If she'd taken the job, where is the job? What's the place we can see there in the picture? If she had taken the job, she would be enjoying her time in London now. Okay, good. Ella, if she had taken the job, her dream would have come true. Yes, nice. That's Ellie, if she had taken the job, she would be in Dubai now. Okay, good. That's a nice one. Safar, if she had taken the job in New York, she could have enjoyed milder weather. Yes. Okay. Lots of good sentences. Aline, if she had taken the job, she would be in London. Yes. Okay. So some of you are using thirds. Some of you are using mixed conditionals. All really good. If she had taken the job, she would live in Paris now, says Halina. Okay, yes, excellent. Lots of people are talking about the opportunities to travel. If she had taken the job, she wouldn't be dreaming now. Yes. So I wonder if any of these situations have ever happened to you, the situations that we have been seeing in the pictures. I think we've got a last question for you here before we finish. So maybe you can think back to the book that we looked at before or the pictures there, and think about your own life and what important decisions have you made in your life, and how would things be different if you'd made different choices? Has anybody got a little example that they can tell us about their own life, something that that you decided to do in the past, and how would things be different in your life now if you'd made a different choice? Has anybody got an example that they can share with us? I think I can see one here from Abo. If I hadn't moved to Qatar, I might have been in Europe now. Okay, great. That's great. Really good grammar you've used there, Abo, and a nice example for us. Excellent. Mona, I'm 13, so I haven't had anything like that. Yeah, good point. I think that maybe this kind of thing, making decisions, it's when we get a bit older that we look back on our lives and say, ah, we could have made different decisions. Maybe when you're 13, it will start soon to have big decisions to make with school subjects and things like that. Safar, if I had taken the opportunities I'd been offered, I would have advanced my career to a better level. Okay, yeah, nice. Perfect grammar there. Have we got any more? Mudassir, if I had not come to visit the British Council page today, I wouldn't have had a good refresher of conditionals for my class tomorrow. Oh, well, I'm pleased to read that. I hope that you feel all ready now for your class, and that you feel ready now with conditionals. That's good to read. May, if I hadn't moved to Australia, I couldn't have been able to have more job opportunities now. Maybe you could say, if I hadn't moved to Australia, I wouldn't have more, or I wouldn't have more job opportunities now. Something like that. If I hadn't decided to live abroad, I wouldn't study English hard. Okay, good. Where did you decide to live abroad? Interesting. Everybody's stories that they've got to tell. If I had moved to Australia, I would have earned a lot of money. Okay, good. So, if I'd made different choices, I wouldn't have three daughters now. Okay, nice, Oksana. I decided to become a teacher. If I hadn't decided to become a teacher, I wouldn't have had a lot of successful university students. Okay, that's something that must be really nice to see your students being successful. If I hadn't followed Learn English, I wouldn't be watching you right now. Yeah, good. Okay, excellent. I think, I would love to read them all actually, because they're all so interesting. Had she taken the job, she would have had enough money for buying a flat. Okay. I like the Safar's comment, if I'd followed my inspiration, I'd be a painter now. Okay, so, Yulia, last one. If I hadn't decided to take further education, I wouldn't have met so many fantastic people here. Oh, that's a really nice comment, Yulia. So it's been really nice reading all your comments. I wish we had time to read all of them, but I'm afraid that's all we've got time for today. So thank you for joining us. I hope it was useful. And if you do fancy reading the book, remember the book we talked about today was called The Midnight Library by Matt Haig. And I would recommend it for anybody maybe with a B2 level and above could maybe read that book. And I hope you enjoy it. I hope you enjoyed today's lesson. And we'll see you again really soon for another grammar lesson. So thanks everybody for coming.